The Colorize neural filter in Photoshop can colorize a black and white photo, but there's a bunch of features there that people are not even aware of that will get you all the way to a perfect colorization. Let's jump in right now. And by the way, guys, if you haven't yet subscribed, hit that subscribe button and turn on notifications and you won't miss any of my tutorials. Here's a black and white photo, which I got from Pixabay. And if you look at the number there, you could find it. All right, let's go ahead and we're going to colorize it. So we're going to choose filter under the neural filters. We're going to choose colorize. Now, when we turn the colorize on, it's going to do a pretty good job of colorizing. Now, there's obviously some issues there and questions I get asked a lot of questions like, well, what if it misses this bit or doesn't get this bit or I want this color? Let me show you how to do that right now. So first thing we're going to do is we are going to tell it what colors we want. So let's start with her sweater because it's not really what we're looking for. So what we do is we click on the area we want to add the color. And say we're gonna give her, I don't know, maybe a purple, but not too bright for this particular scene. Click OK. And now it's sort of giving us the color, but let's go, we're gonna click it again and let's reduce the saturation because I feel like it's still too saturated. There we go, that's better. But notice it's not quite reaching the sleeve and the rest of the image. The first thing we can do is we can increase the size. And this will spread it a little bit further and see if that does a better job. The next thing we can do is we can duplicate this. All we need to do is just simply click and it will add another point of exactly the same color. In fact, it looks like that sleeve leads a little bit and I can click there and we can get that. Now notice there's a little bit of bleeding and artifact. If we go down and we choose a color artifact reduction, this will reduce some of those and smoothen it out. Excellent. What if we want to add the boot and make the boot brown? Well, if we click here, notice it's going to pick up our purplish color. All we need to do is click on the color swatch and let's change it to a brownish tone. Great. Now, if I add another point somewhere, maybe up in the road here, it's going to pick up that brown. See what it does? It picks up that previous color. So it's going to keep doing that. In fact, let's do a little bit more in the foreground so we can start to get some of that color and let's spread it out. Great. Now, as you can see, though, we still have some areas in here, you know, such as his hand and some different things like that that need cleaning up. Let me show you the next step. But before I do, if you want to get rid of any of these, all you need to do is select it and then just hit that little minus key. And that will get rid of any of those. All right, let's take it to the next level. If we scroll down, we have the option to output as a new color layer. And what this does is it creates just a colorization. We're gonna click OK to apply it. Now, if we look at this, what we have is our black and white image, and then on top, we have it in color blend mode. If we look at the regular image, that's what it looks like. The color blend mode will protect the luminosity and only change the color. Now, sometimes all you've got to do is just take the opacity down a little bit and that will actually get you a better result. In this case, we're going to paint. So what we're going to do is grab a brush. So you want to hit the B key to grab your brush. All right, so if we wanted to get some of this color, what we do is we sample it by holding down the Alt or the Option key. Now, before you do, you want to make sure you're sampling a decent amount. So there is actually an adjustment for the eyedropper, but you won't find it here in the brush. You've got to go into the eyedropper. I don't want this to be point sample because that's going to just get us an individual pixel, which could be anything. Let's do an 11 by 11 average. So it's going to average that tone now, and that will work wherever the eyedropper is. So let's hold down the Alt or the Option key. Let's sample that color. Make the brush a little bit bigger. And as we paint now, we can paint with this brush. Make sure our flow and opacity, let's just turn it up so we can just quickly get there. What about a sweater here? Well, let's just sample some white, paint on the sleeve. And as you can see there, I'm able to just sample these colors and mix them pretty easily. And this is also really good for getting rid of, you know, color casts from color gels and different things like that. I've done another tutorial. I'll link that in the show notes. And by the way, drop a comment, guys. Let me know if this is useful. What do you think about this colorization filter? I'd love to hear your thoughts on it. And by the way, if you're new, welcome to Photoshop Cafe. Consider hitting that subscribe button and turn on notifications. You won't miss any of my videos. And anyway, guys, do me a favor, hit that like button. It helps us with the YouTube algorithm. Why is that such a tongue twister? All right, guys. Till next time, I'll see you at the cafe.